What are some of the things that we do not know about the ascendant, ascendant lord, the Lagna lord? He's a very important planet in the horoscope. So there are things which we know that the Lagna lord shows focus, the prime areas of focus, not the prime focus, the prime, one of the prime areas of focus, apart from the sun and the moon. But there's yet something which I see many people do not use, and it's very crucial. This is something which is irrespective of your dashas and transits that you should be using. And if you use this, then you will be able to understand how the dashas will give results, how the planets will show their characteristics, or they will show your characteristics. Alright, so as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it down below. And if you want a consultation, my website is also down below in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and He will be there, irrespective of who is your ascendant lord. So what is the Lagna lord? Lagnesha. Lagna is the rising sign from the eastern horizon. Now, the Lagna lord, I have many videos on Lagna lord, Lagna, Lagnesh, please watch them. So here what I would like to speak is the Lagna lord. So suppose your Lagna lord is moon, you're a Cancer rising. Then the Lagna lord, or the sign in the Lagna, gives you, see, the Lagna lord is like the king of the house, because when you say I have a planet in the fifth house, what does it mean? It means fifth from the ascendant. That's by default understood. So that means whenever you are saying any planet is in a particular house, you are putting the Lagna as the reference point. That means from his fifth house, right? The house from his fifth house, his ninth house, his tenth house, his 11th house, his 12th house. So therefore, the Lagna, the sign in the Lagna, will tell you how do you view the world. Because suppose a person has a moon in Cancer, for example, or not moon in Cancer, moon in Pisces, for example. So for one day, 2 days, that moon will be in the same sign. Of course, the nakshatra can be different, of course. But let's forget nakshatras in them for time being. Let's take the zodiac sign only. So that this planet, moon, will be in Pisces for at least 2 days. So then, if you take even one day, then all the people who are born will have moon in Pisces. But then why are they so different? Because from the ascendant, this moon is placed in Pisces but in a different house. So that means this person who is born in the morning and who is born in the evening, who is born in the afternoon or in the night or during Brahma Muhurat, they are all viewing this same moon in Pisces from a different angle, from a different perspective. What they think about moon in Pisces, if somebody is born in 3 a.m. in the morning, is totally different from what a person who is born at 9 a.m. in the morning thinks about moon in Pisces. That is why if you read about Pisces, moon in Pisces, or Pisces sign in general, you will see that, you know, Pisces is very dreamy, dreary, confused, could be very merciful, could be very romantic sometimes, could be very forgiving, or could be very cruel sometimes, very moody, very anxious, full of anxiety and depression, full of addictions. Okay, so now that's why you may think, oh, if my moon is in Pisces or any zodiac, will I have all these traits? Which of them will I have? Which of them will I not have? So that means from the ascendant. So for example, if somebody is a Gemini Lagna, for example, so then this Gemini Lagna person will view this moon in Pisces from a perspective of 10th house. Because Pisces is the 10th house. So this means that this behavior of moon in Pisces will impact him or her most in which house? In the 10th house. If somebody is a Virgo ascendant, then for them this moon in Pisces will impact them the most when it comes to the marriage. That means these houses will decide how this moon in Pisces will behave. So therefore, the ascendant is the reference point from which everything is decided. Okay, so how you view this world is decided from the ascendant. So for example, if somebody is a Gemini ascendant, then what happens is the traits of Gemini will be found in every single house. So the sign in the ascendant is like a filter. So for example, suppose this is a Gemini ascendant, okay? And then there are these houses, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, like this, 12 houses. So imagine somebody is shooting you. Okay, imagine Gemini's 7th house, which is Sagittarius, takes a gun and shoots at Gemini, okay? Or shoots at you. So then what happened? That bullet will be filtered through the sign of Gemini, which means anything that a Gemini ascendant sees, because the Lagna, the word used for Lagna is Dhi, Dhi Mahi, as Srimad Bhagavatam says. So anything that happens in your life will be governed through the filter of intelligence, and the intelligence will have traits of this zodiac sign. So anything that comes to you, whatever life throws at you, will be filtered through this sign, will be filtered through this zodiac, will be filtered through this sign in the ascendant. So that means if somebody is a Gemini ascendant, anything happens either in matters of second house, which is finance, family, third house, siblings, fourth house, mother, home, property, or you know, fifth house, children, sixth house, job, seventh house, marriage, eighth house, in-laws, ninth house, father, 10th house job, 11th house gains, 12th house losses. They will always, always, always try to filter it through the sign of Gemini. What does it mean? It means they will see if there is something which they might look for a quick fix. Okay? Because Gemini people are very good at quick fixes. You know, may not be very good at long-term fixes, but quick fix something. Quickly, just do it. Just see if you can maneuver through it very fast. Now, I'm not saying this is good or this is bad, but this is a trait which they may have for every particular house. So therefore, it's essential that when you are, sometimes people talk of this, you know, astrology, Kundalini Milan, matching, Kundalini Milan and all this, or compatibility and all this. So therefore, you will see that if a person has a mercurial ascendant, so for example, Virgo or Gemini, for example, primarily Virgo, I would say, then these things are really very important to them, because they really want to know if I will be compatible and what will be my frequency with them. You know, this Gun Milan and compatibility, this is more of a mercurial stuff than a Venusian stuff, I would say, although it looks like it's Venusian. But of course, the, within the Gun Milan, there are many things, you know, like for this compatibility, that compatibility, this is required, that is required. But in general, I am saying, you know, that these two ascendants may be more prone to giving more importance to all this. Or, you know, having a good communication. Now, you may think that, oh, but the sign for a Gemini in the seventh house is Sagittarius, right? Why in the universe is Mercury so important? Because Mercury is not their seventh lord. But as I said, anything that happens in any house for Gemini Lagna will be as it's like it's like Gemini actually. Every house is like Gemini. So every house is like the sign in the ascendant. Every house is filtered through that zodiac sign. So therefore, you will always realize this when you are doing consultations or you are looking at horoscopes, maybe of your own or your family horoscopes, that you tell them something. Okay, seventh lord is in the 11th house. Okay, some prediction you give them. It's in this nakshatra, this will happen, that will happen. You know, you'll go abroad and then you'll find your spouse. Or the moment you get married, you'll go abroad, something like this. If the 12th house is linked, 9th house is linked. And then the person is like, okay, but doesn't sound like me. I mean, the person may say, but I'm not interested in going abroad and finding somebody, or I'm not interested to go abroad once I get married, something like this. Why? Because the sign in the ascendant and the planets in the ascendant and the ascendant lord may be giving you a different flavor. So whenever you see any individual placement, in the horoscope. Always remember that that is not how the person views that placement. Okay. So if seventh lord is in the sixth, you may think that the person is not interested in marriage. But you will see thousands and millions of people having seventh lord in sixth or sixth lord in the seventh, very interested in marriage. Why in the universe? This is because of their ascendant. Okay? This is because of their ascendant lord and planets in the ascendant. So it's very, very, very crucial that you understand that anything in life, either it's the same with career also, everything they will filter through it. Okay? So therefore, if you give them some blind prediction, oh, 10th lord is in, you know, 6th house, so very good for job or whatever, self-employment or could be business also. But then the ascendant may not agree to that. The ascendant may say that, you know, okay, you are saying job, but I like business more. Like, for example, if somebody is a Leo ascendant, Leo people, they are very much independent mind. Okay. And that is why they are miserable many times I have seen, because they want to do everything themselves. So then even if a person, if a Leo ascendant has a Venus in sixth, why Venus? Because Venus is the 10th lord. You say, oh, it's good if you do job. But then the person, maybe if the person has more combination, which makes a person more independent minded, then the person may be averse to working under somebody. The person may say, oh, I want to do a business or self-employment. So here the same 10th lord in the 6th can give a totally different flavor for a Leo ascendant compared to somebody who's a Taurus lagna. Okay, totally different flavor. Why? It's the same placement. It's the same damn lord. Okay. So therefore, that's what I wanted to say. All right. So that will be all from my side. Thank you very much for your patience. And if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it below. And if you want a consultation, please go to my website below. Okay. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you'll find him.